Hello everyone and welcome to this new lecture series of AWS Foundation course of Machine Learning using SageMaker. So now in these courses, what we are going to see, we are going to cover different labs and we are going to see the challenge lab. So without wasting time, let's jump on to and see what we have got. Now this is module 3, this is AWS Machine Learning Foundation course. Code is 7108 as you can see here, and this is the lab interface of AWS SageMaker. Now this is lab 3.1 because in this course the first lab you will face is in module 3, and this is a guided lab. This is non-credited, you don't need to score anything, any minimum threshold to get certified for this course. The purpose is to make you familiar with AWS SageMaker interface, and if you scroll down you'll see what are the different objectives. There are some prerequisite obviously, because now this is based on cloud service of Amazon, so you need internet connectivity, you need OS, any OS will do, you need some authorization, you need AWS account for sure. And this is the lab interface. So here if you see, there is start lab, there is end lab, and there are some timings mentioned here. So first thing, we'll click on this start lab and this will provide you with the lab session. Do remember that you have to end the lab as well after you are done with your project work, your learning phase. So a pop-up will appear here, and if you see here, it is written that lab status is in creation. Now this is going to be a bit lengthy session, because in this session I'm not going to fast forward anything. I'll just wait and see how much time it actually takes to create anything. Like here the lab status, how much time it's taking to start the lab, and in later phases we are using these Amazon SageMakers, so definitely we'll be creating some instances. So here lab status is ready, it didn't take much time. Now let's scroll down and see what we have got here to do. So okay, so at the top of this instruction, choose the start lab. We did that, start lab panel also appeared, and we close that after everything is started. Now choose AWS, here it is. Let's click on this AWS, and what it will do, a new tab will open of Amazon Management Console. So what we have to do here, okay, a new browser tab is opening, and a tip is here that if it is not opening in your browser, then check for pop-ups, pop-up setting. If it is blocked, then go for allow pop-ups. It is saying that arrange the AWS management console here, but let's just switch it, don't arrange it. Now on AWS management console, go to Amazon SageMaker. So if you see here, as I've already used certain services, they will appear here, but since you are opening it for first time, click on this all services, and in all services you have to scroll down and look out for machine learning section. Here it is, machine learning, and there you can see Amazon SageMaker section is also there. So what we'll do, we'll click on this Amazon SageMaker, and the next time when you'll open it, it will appear in recent section. See here, now you have to go to notebook instances and create notebook instance. Let's see here, okay, this is Amazon SageMaker interface, and left side there it is notebook. We'll create on notebook, we'll click on notebook instance, and you see currently it is empty, there are no instances created. So what we'll do, we'll create one by clicking on this create notebook instance. Let's click on this and see what happens. Now notebook instance setting is there, notebook instance name, as I saw it was my notebook written in the documentation step. You can name it anything, but let's follow the tutorial for the time being. So now from the notebook instance type drop list, choose ml.m4.xlarge. okay, so here it is, notebook instance type, and this is the drop down menu. Let's scroll down, it's not visible here, scrolling and yeah, there it is, ml.m4.xlarge. Let's select it. Now what? Under additional in configuration, choose the drop down menu for life cycle configuration and choose the life cycle configuration that contains ml pipeline. Okay, so we don't have to do anything here, just scroll down. There it is, additional configuration. Let's click on this life cycle configuration drop down. We have to select this ml pipeline. There it is. So we'll select this ml pipeline as mentioned in the steps. Now this will automatically add. Okay, leave the remaining settings and choose create notebook instance. Okay, so okay, and then it will take 2 to 5 minutes for notebook instance to start. Okay, so let's click on this. Let's scroll down. There it is, create notebook instance. Let's click on this create notebook instance button. Now a message is there, success, your notebook instance is being created. If you see here, my notebook is there, the instance type is ml.m4.xlarge and status is pending. Okay, so it is still creating, and if you see, it is written that it will take 2 to 5 minutes. So let's check our patience at the time being, and at the end then choose open Jupyter. So after the status is in service or not pending or whatever, then some Jupyter notebook action will appear. This action section is currently empty. So in the meantime, let's discuss this thing here. So these notebook instances are not free, and if you are using Amazon free tier, then you can use it free up to certain duration. And if you have some academies associated with you, or you have some Amazon services, you buy some Amazon services, then you can use it obviously for free. And the purpose is, see here, let's scroll and see what are the different tasks we are going to see. So the task 2 is that we are going to jump onto Jupyter notebook section and we'll see some Python cheat sheet. So still it is pending, it will take time. Now since task 2 is about Jupyter notebook, let me just give you a brief that if you are not familiar with Jupyter interface, then I'll ask you to either use Google Colab or Anaconda package or Jupyter Lab itself. Now Jupyter interface is very popular in Python, in machine learning world, and if you know, then the famous Kaggle is also using Jupyter interface. So I'll ask you, if you are not familiar, then get familiar with Jupyter. If you see here, there is one section, North Virginia. Now these are different reasons, and these reasons are not important at the time being, but when you are using some other services, or you are creating instances using codes, then you need to define these reasons as well. Okay, so for our operation at this moment, it is North Virginia. So here in our next task, we are going to open this Python cheat sheet in the Jupyter lab once it will get created. So that will be our task 2. And I feel that this task is to just make you familiar with SageMaker desktop. And if you are not familiar with Jupyter notebook, then see here, code cells, markdown cells. So you will get familiar with Jupyter notebook also here. Let's see, again it is still pending. So literally it is taking 2 to 5 minutes, but still we are not hurrying down. Let's wait for the first time. So you'll get familiar with notebook shortcuts, like to execute any cell, either you can use shift enter, or you can use run button, or you can choose run cells. So these are different options if you are familiar with Jupyter notebook. Then task 3 is to open a sample notebook. Okay, So we have got one linear underscore learner underscore MNIST notebook, and this is task 3 that we have to open it and then create a copy of that. The task 4 is importing data. Okay, and I think this is the most important task because our lab name is also this, create and import data. And here you have to choose file, then choose notebook, then you have to select the kernel also, which is Python 3 Anaconda, conda underscore Python 3. Okay, and then so these are different tasks, and then you have to use the cell as markdown cell, and you have to, if you know markdown, it means that you can convert your cell into a writing pad. And then you have to import the different libraries here. Okay, and then they are also teaching you that how to execute different cells, how to execute more than one cell simultaneously. If you see here, it is written that exit the cell without running the code by pressing escape. Okay, so you'll get familiar with Jupyter Notebook here, and then you have to fetch the data from URL, and then you will learn to execute more than one cell simultaneously. That is pretty good. Okay, so these are the different tasks we are going to perform in this lab 3.1. so I am getting the idea that they are making you familiar with SageMaker, they are making you familiar with Jupyter Notebook. And see here, you are also going to read data, and task 5 is optional, that is downloading the notebook and saving your work, that is optional. So okay, let's see here, let's jump back to where we started actually, that is task 2. Task 1 is done, we are now in task 2. And okay, now if you see, the status is in service. Let's open this Jupyter lab. You can use Open Jupyter. I'm using Open Jupyter lab as mentioned. And let's wait for the Jupyter notebook, Jupyter lab interface to load. Let's see how much time it takes here. I think it will not take much time. Let's see. Okay, so it is loading, and if you see, okay, few seconds now, clear workspace. Okay, let's clear. Now the interface is opened. If you see here, let's click on the documentation, and you see there is Jupyter Lab UI, open the Python cheat sheet, but I can see nothing was there like this, what is written here. It may be some old documentation when cheat sheet was visible directly, but what I see, the visibility is of the kernels, and we saw there something kernel. Let's see where it is. Not here. Let's see here it is. So it is written in point 22 that select kernel dialog window, choose conda python, but if you see here, already there is list of kernels available here. I think we can select one directly at the moment, and we need conda python 3. Now there are different kernels, you see there is MXNet, there is Python 3, there is PyTorch, but we are interested in Python 3 Anaconda kernel. Let's click on this, and a new Jupyter notebook is opened here. Okay, but okay, we can right click on it, we can rename it, and we can download it from here. That was our optional task. We'll do it if we want it, to rename it or to download it, the Jupyter file. Currently we are not interested in that. What we want Python cheat sheet. And if you see, Python cheat sheet dot ipynb file is not visible directly. If you read here, is anything written? In this task, we'll explore in the Jupyter Labs GUI, open the Python cheat sheet. Now, this notebook is not directly visible. Clearly, earlier it may be visible, but now in these new interface, it is not visible directly. I think there are certain folders and it may be present in some folder. Let's click on this English US. There it is, Python cheat sheet. Let's double click on it and it will open in the main window here. So it is opening. So if you see in the documentation, it was not written that Python cheat sheet is in some folder. Maybe in earlier versions it was, but now it is inside some folder, inside English underscore US folder. Okay, that's not problem. We are done through this. Now there is no task, just it is Python cheat sheet. It was to open, and if you see, this cheat sheet is a good brush up knowledge of Python. If you see, there are lists, tuples, dictionaries, comments. So it is pretty handy cheat sheet. If you are familiar with Python, then you see it is covering syntax, white space, comment, number operation, to some advanced topic of pandas. Obviously it will not teach you Python, but if you are familiar with Python, if you are familiar with NumPy, pandas, then you can go through it, have some brush up knowledge. It will be very helpful in later task as well. Okay, so let's see what we have now. So we have opened this Python cheat sheet and let's scroll down. So there are some icons and I think they are talking about these things. This is file browser, git, again git, then it is notebook tools, then open tabs, then some table of content, and Amazon SageMaker sample notebooks. Okay, so in documentation part, they are talking about these things, these symbols. And if you see here, okay, this is file browser, list of kernels, git repository, Amazon SageMaker samples, and then obviously about Jupyter cells they are talking. Now I'm not going deep into these things, we'll learn it by using it. Now let's start with task 3, and that is opening a sample notebook. And if you see, switch the left navigation and visit to Amazon SageMaker sample. So we just saw the last one is Amazon SageMaker sample, and there are plenty of notebooks available here. So we have to select one notebook, and that is, here it is, linear underscore learner underscore minist ipynb. So let's search it. Linear, there it is, I see linear underscore learner minist. We'll click on it and it will load up here. Okay, I've clicked it more than once. So this is, you see, this is read only. Let me get rid of one, let me close one. So this is linear MNST read only mode, and the task is, if you see, the task is to create a copy. So for creating a copy, there is one button you can see here, just click on it. Create a copy option is there, and it is creating copy, and you have to select the kernel as well again. So I'll choose conda underscore python 3 here, and let's select it. Okay, so now if you see, this is, let's get rid of this read only also. So this is the linear learner MNST file. This was our task 3. And if you know, if you have any idea about machine learning, then MNIST is a data set of numbers. There are numbers from 0 to 9, handwritten digit set, and we build machine models to predict different types of numbers. So this is basically the Hello World program of machine learning. Okay, so this was our task 3, pretty simple. Now let's move on to task 4, and that is importing data. So in machine learning, the first task is to import data. So this is going to be pretty handful. So file, go to new and create new notebook here. So let me create it. A new notebook will appear in the main working window. Again, we'll choose the conda underscore python 3 kernel. Let's select it and this is the notebook created. Let's see, we are done with this. We have selected the kernel. Now press M on the keyboard, press M, and the cell in drop down menu will turn to markdown cell. So this cell, this is at the moment it is coding cell. If we press M, you can see now it has been turned to markdown cell, and we have to write here hash and importing the data. It is written here, we just few moment earlier we read it, importing the data. So let me write hash importing the data. And if you are not familiar with Python, with Jupyter in notebooks, then I tell you that hash is used to decide the size of the font. You can run it or you can use shift enter. Let me press shift enter to execute this cell. So when I press the shift enter, see here, the so I was using single hash, it means it is title with big size, big fonts. If you use double hash, the size will decrease. Triple hash, again size will decrease, so and so on. So to exit the cell, press shift enter, we did that. Now we have to download the data from internet, and in this part we are using URL, okay, and the file is a zip file as it is mentioned here. So you can download the zip file, extract it on local machine and fetch it using some libraries, but since this file is small, we are going to download the file directly using URL. So first we are going to import some necessary libraries. Again, you don't need to learn these libraries because these are standard libraries. You are not using any logic here, you are not creating your own library. Set the indentation correct, otherwise it will throw indentation error here. Okay, these are some libraries, and we have not to execute this cell. This is again the part of task. We don't have to execute this cell. It is written that exit the cell without running the code by pressing escape. Okay, and so what we have to do, we have to press the escape button. So we'll come out of this cell, the cursor will come out of this cell without executing it. Then I am using plus to get the new cell, but it is mentioned in the documentation to use B button. Let's see, there it is, 28 number point, add a cell below by pressing B. So I used plus, you can use B also. Now we have to fetch the URL, so let's copy this. Again, these are standard statements. So what we are doing, we are fetching a zip file from the URL directly, storing it in some variable f_zip, and then again we don't have to run this cell also. This is again the part of the task of this lab. What we have to do now, see here, exit the cell without running the code like the previous one. Now we have to select the two code cells by holding shift and choosing both cell. So what we'll do, we'll press shift and we'll select both cell. Okay, press shift and then click on these two cells. If you see, the background is light blue, it means these two cells are selected, and then we'll run these. So anything is mentioned here, I'll run this using shift enter, and see it is also saying that run the code in the two cells by pressing shift enter. Again, you can use run button also, no issues. So okay, these asterisk marks are denoting that these two cells are being executed, and now they are done, they are done executing. So in the file viewer, in the left navigation pane, you should see four new files. Okay, so let's see, in the file viewer, I think the top left, this is Amazon SageMaker, top left, that is, this is file browser, and see here, four new files have been created by running these two cells. Okay, good. And there are four tabs here opened here, no problems with that. So we are successfully doing the lab task. Now what, load the files into the main working window by clicking each file examine the data in these files. What format is the data? Does the data have column headings? And there are some questions. Okay, so let's click on this. And when you click this, these files will open in the window. And if you see here, what they are saying, that analyze this data. So you can analyze this anytime by just investing some more time. Superficially, I can say that these are some rows and some columns data, like in Excel sheet. More or less, they are. This is some data frame. Data frame is nothing but rows and columns. And now we'll read one file using pandas. So let's copy this and let's paste it here. Again, before executing, do the indentation, otherwise indentation error exception will be thrown out. So what we are doing, we have imported the libraries, we fetch one zip file from the URL, we stored it here, we unzipped it, and now we are reading one file from these four files. See, column underscore 2c underscore veka dot arff, that one, that file we are going to read, and it's a data frame. We are using df.head function from pandas. It will, what it will do, it will give me first five rows and all columns values here. So this is pretty much some bio data, some parts, body part, pelvic body part. So we'll analyze more in our next task. And now the last task is downloading and notebook saving. That is optional. You can just go and click on the untitled part, right click and name it. For the time being, we can conclude it. Thank you, and we'll see in the next lecture.